Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to have a quick recap on what we have talked about, the formic component, and then we will talk about formic as a higher order component, formic with the context. Okay, so formic component we have done, and we are using formic, form, field and error message. All these components we were using in our previous videos, and this is how we are validating the form object using schema, right? So there are many things. While initializing the form, you can actually load some predefined values. So here you can access the props, which I talked in the previous video also, and you can set, you can initialize the values from some values which are coming from props. Props.name, props.email. If your parent component is supplying some initializer value, so this is called as a loading the values in the form. Okay. Next thing is validation. Here we are using validation schema, signup schema, which is taking care of the name and email field. Okay. Next thing is how we are using this form, field, error message component. So error message is a custom built in component which are wrapped on top of HTML form component. So here we can see our form is now very small. Even if you keep adding few more fields, it's not going to be a big component, right? Here you can add a new field which is form name, email, you can say password. You just need to take care of the name field, type is password, and here error message, you need to pass the name component. Okay, and here just add the validation. In the validation, you will just add for password, that password length and all. Password first of all is required, so it will be of string. So we can just put min and max. And the required, because it is a string, so we can make the same validation criteria. Maximum is too big, 10, so we can, let's make it, it's too short, too long, its max is 10, max is, let's say, 11, and it is required, right? So this is how we added the validation. Now first of all, loading the values from the props, then doing the validation, then whenever the form is getting submitted, then how you are going to tackle that, right? So here we are getting the reset form. So once the form is submitted, here we are getting all the values in the values, right? And here you can write async await. So async await you can write in the set timeout also. So here you can just do await some call, and you will pass this values data. Values is an object. Okay, this is async function. You can also make this whole function as an async function, and here we are writing await, right? Now in this we are getting the data, we are making some API call, and once this API call is succeeded, we can do the reset form. So this is a direct utility which will reset your form, set the empty values as an empty, and it's submitting. Here in the, from the props we are getting the errors, touched, and it's submitting. Now as we are using this form and error message component, we don't need the errors and touched property, because rest all things are being taken care by this form tag, form and field tag. Okay, we just need it submitting property to show the transition, like when you click on button, it will show the wait until we got the response from the API call. Okay, so what we will do is, if we just see the demo how it works, currently we are just having set timeout. So set timeout will just wait for 2 seconds. After that, it will just set the button label as a submit. Okay, we obviously need not these things. Now this is our form. All are required. So I can just add text. I didn't add a placeholders. Okay, this is password. Too long, let's make it short, right? Now it is waiting for it, right? So you can disable this also. We can have add the disable tag also here. Whenever your form is getting submitted, do not allow user to click on it. It's submitting, then it will disable it. So all these things, so this is a quick recap, right? We covered everything, validations, how to initialize the form values, how to submit the values to some API call. You can on submit, you can convert it into async await method, which we have seen in the previous method also, and you can write await functions here. We can API call. Okay, this is how you can do it. Okay, and once the submission is done, you can reset the form, you can show the error, you can show the toasters, all these things can happen. Okay, so this is how we are writing the forms. Now in the next video, let's take a look on the higher order component with Formic.